Barbados and Bridgetown in particular was a commercial centerpiece of the Caribbean. Our large-scale firms in Bridgetown were giant shopkeeping firms. Commission agents, they were called, DaCosta, Mannings, Musson, Cape Shepherd, Gardner, Austin, Goddard's. These were firms along our main street, Broad Street, which dealt in import and export. They were called the Big Six, Barbados Shipping and Trading, Gardner, Austin, DaCosta, Cape Shepherd, Goddard's, Mannings, etc. They brought in everything from lumber to safety pins and put them in their stores, their show windows and stalls for people to purchase. And this is in essence what commerce in Barbados was about. Small scale operators, entrepreneurs, hawkers, hucksters, vendors, they were literally banned from our Main Street, Broad Street. You did not find them on Main Street. Main Street, Broad Street was for fashionable people, was the Caribbean's Fifth Avenue. Only the fashionable and the rich, the famous and white had their stores on Broad Street. And the rich, the famous, the white, browns and blacks who had money shopped on Broad Street. People who were dark-skinned and who did not have a lot of money did not shop on Broad Street. You went to Swan Street. In fact, the first black to come onto Broad Street was a man called Newman Ethan Wilson, a Grenadian, very dark-skinned, very forceful character, came here after the Second World War and established himself, N.E. Wilson, at the top of Broad Street, Trafalgar Street to be exact. N.E. Wilson used to advertise his goods as the Broad Street store with Swan Street prices, so people would not feel that they're trespassing on Broad Street or Trafalgar Street, but that they would come looking for Swan Street prices, and here was a place on Broad Street where you would find them. And he broke the monopoly of the Big Six on Broad Street. Nobody else looking like him, not even Browns, not even Indians, could traffic their goods on our Main Street, Broad Street. And that is until quite recently. As a matter of fact, up to today, no black Barbadian has any business of note on Broad Street.